Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about multiple activity chart. The learning outcome will be, you will be able to draw a multiple activity chart. You will be able to draw a multiple activity chart for man-machine interaction. The session will be in the following sequence. We will be going for the introduction, then significance and importance of the multiple activity chart, how to construct a multiple activity chart, and we will be studying some examples of man-machine type multiple activity charts. What is a multiple activity chart? Well, a multiple activity chart is a chart on which the activities of more than one subject, worker or machines are each recorded on a common scale to show their interrelationship. As we know, multiple activity chart is one of the recording techniques in the method study, and the recording techniques are generally classified in the two categories. One is called as charts on a time scale and the chart without time scale. Multiple activity chart happens to be a chart with time scale, and the different types of multiple activity charts are there. The first one is man-machine type chart, where one operator is working on machine. It is a one-to-one correspondence, like a lathe machine or a conventional drilling machine, conventional CNC machine, where one operator is working on one machine. Another type is man multi-machine type chart, when a single operator is working on number of machines. Generally, this is the case where a automat is there when the setting is done by operator, and he can operate generally two or three machines at a time. Generally, in terms of a radial drilling machine also, we have got such type of arrangement. Multi-man on the same machine chart, when a group of workers are working on a machine. Such cases are generally happening in the big planing machines or big presses, where there will be two to four operators at four locations on the machine, and all simultaneously operate the machine. So such case is generally called as multi-man and same machine chart. And there is a multi-man, multi-machine chart, when group of operators are working on multiple machines. This is a general example in case of a group layout, where we will find group of workers are working on a particular machine. This type of picture is generally commonly observed in case of a fixed position layout. The significance and importance of the multiple activity chart is, the chart shows different activities of operator and machine on a common scale. It shows period of idleness on the part of the machine or the man. It is possible to arrange these activities so that such ineffective time is reduced. The whole purpose of multiple activity chart is, we are on a time scale, we are trying to find out what is the utilization and occupancy of the operator and what is the utilization of the machine or the equipment. Ultimately, we will be able to coming out with the what is the ineffective time or idle time of the operator or the machine, and then we try to maximize the utilization of the either resource, either operator or the machine, or in some cases both of them simultaneously. The timing, we are taking it on a time scale, the timing should be accurate enough for the chart to be effective. It can also be used for the picture of operation performed simultaneously by worker and machines. In some cases, if the layout is new, or if you have a new equipment or a new machine installed in that, and we are interested to find out how many operators are required for that particular machine, then we will be able to, by drawing a multiple activity chart, we will be able to find out number of operators required for a particular given job. How to construct a multiple activity chart? The separate bars and columns are allocated for each subject. These subjects are placed against common time scale. Activities of worker and machines are recorded by shading the respective bars or the columns. Shading indicates the occupancy or the utilization, and idleness is shown by the blank of that particular column. Then the activities are plotted in the sequence against a common time scale. Here is an example of a multiple activity chart, where is a case of one operator, one machine. Just look to the variety of columns. You will find that the first column is a time scale, second is operator, the third column indicates the time required for that. This is the part of the operator. On the second, the next column is indicating the time scale for the machine activity, time required for that machine activity, and finally, what is the remark of this. For example, first we start with the description. The time scale 0.2 is indicating that we are starting the watch, and then we are starting that pick up the job from the rack. A job is picked from the rack and it is generally taking 0.2 minutes. All the time scales are shown in minutes. 0.2 minutes for the operator to take the job and pick up from the rack. In that case, we are not doing anything on the machine, so therefore naturally machine will be idle. Next part is 0.28. The time scale, the watch continuously goes on, it is on cumulative basis. The operator is doing activity of loading the job in the machine. And the time required for this will be the difference between this time and the previous time. 0.28 minus 0.2, it will be 0.08 minutes will be the total time required for the operator to load the job. Again, in this case, machine remains idle. Next activity is switching on the machine. The time is showing as 0.36 and the total time required for that activity will be 0.08 minutes. In this case, machine is also required because he is operating the machine. Therefore, both are shown as in the hatched area and both are required, both are occupied. Once the machine is started, machine is put on the auto cycle. Therefore, machining continues, and machining part on auto cycle, which takes around 1.5 minutes. In this case, machine is working and operator is idle. So therefore, in the column of operator, we are showing it as idle, and machine we are showing it as busy or occupied. Once that is there, the next activity will be pick up the part, in which case the part is picked up and therefore it takes 0.05 times and the machine remains idle. Afterwards, the job is picked and then job is kept in the tray, in which case the time required by the operator is 0.05 minutes and the total time in the machine will be remain in this idle case. So this will be the a single very short cycle activity of loading the job, putting auto cycle and taking the job away from that. The total time distribution of this will be operator's working time will be 0.46 minutes, idle time will be 1.5 minute, machine time will be 1.66 working time and 0.3 minutes as the idle time. So this will show the multiple activity chart that which particular operator or the machine is busy and how much time it is busy and how much time it is idle. The next is, now we have to think of how to draw a multiple activity chart in the case of one operator and two machines. We have to think of it. Now this is a solution for your problem. On the left hand scale, we have got the time scale, then operator number one, operator one, machine number one and machine number two. We have to continue the same sequence of operations as we are doing it for one operator, one machine. Only in this case, the first operator will work on the machine number one. In this case, operator and machine number work, machine number one will be working, machine number two will be idle in that case. Afterwards, once the machine number one is set on auto mode, then operator will now naturally move to the machine number two. And therefore, in the further case, operator and machine number two will be busy. Once both machines are working, it may happen that machines are running and the operator is idle. So this way the cycle will continue. Only in this case, initially, when both machines are at idle, some portion of time machine number 2 will remain idle until the machine number 1 goes into the auto cycle. So that will be the initial startup idle time for the machines. So afterwards, probably when the continuation of the shift, we can adjust this balancing also, and then we can continue for this particular point. The total time distribution in this such case will be operator total time will be 3 minutes, idle time 1 minute, machine number 1 3.5, idle time 0.5, machine number 2 2.5 minutes and idle time will be 1.5 minute. So by this we will be able to find out the total percentage of operator's time, idle time on the machine number 1, idle time on the machine number 2, and we can think of whether the same operator can run third machine or fourth machine. It may happen that we are running multiple machines. What will be the idleness of the operator and what will be the idleness especially for the remaining machines of 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now there is a big, pretty typical, a tricky question. While utilizing the resource, operator or machine, the question is whether utilization of the machine should be given a priority or utilization of the person should be given a priority. The answer is, of course, tricky. Can you think of this and tell the answer? The answer is, it is not a straightforward answer like we have to give utilization of machine or utilization of person as a priority. It depends upon the type and value of the resource. If the machine is of high value and the constraint resource, then we have to go for the utilization of the machine. And in the other case, we have to go for the operator. In such cases, the machine is of high value, machine time is constant, even it may be economical and productive to have two operators operating on a single machine, because we want to get more machine running time as compared to the operator. This can be possible by adjusting the setup and set changeover time for those cases. These are some of the references which I have used. Thank you.